Hello, welcome to White Threads FlossTube number 71. Thank you so much for joining me today. Thank you to all the people who have signed up to my blog and also subscribed to my YouTube channel since my last video, when we talked about the problems with Facebook and the fact that we can't rely on it, whether now or into the future. So the best way for me to be able to keep in contact with you so that you know that there's a new video here is for you to subscribe to both. So thank you for those who have done that. And if you haven't yet, there's still time, obviously. So today I'm going to show you another project from my forthcoming book, Frisian Whitework, Dutch Embroidery from Friesland. I'm also going to talk to you about two exhibitions that I know that are on in Europe soon. And of course, depends on lockdowns, doesn't it? But yeah, there's something to look forward to once you come out of lockdowns for those who are in those regions. And I've got some fabric to show you as well. So first of all, the thing I want to show you is the project for today. And I'm going to hopefully fit the whole thing in. I've no idea, it probably didn't. This is a runner which has got a band of Frisian whitework down each end. So it measures, I didn't measure it before I started and I can't remember off the top of my head, so I'll put that on the screen for you. It's worked on, yeah, don't really remember that either. This isn't going well, is it? Okay, I'm back and I've brought with me my copy of my proof that has arrived from a printer. So this is what a printer's proof looks like. It's got a digital proof of the front cover, and then we also have, these are called ozolids. I have no idea why, don't know what it means, but these are all of the pages as they fit together in the book. So I need to check these, which I have done, and approve them and then send them back to the printer. But what it does mean is that I can look at the book and find out the information for you. So I'm just going to do that. Okay, so I had a look and it measures about 45 by 60 centimeters or 18 by 24 inches, and it's worked on 28 count linen. There you go. I have all this information when I bothered to look it up. So that's, I'll go back to showing you the project. Hold this up out of the way. Anyway, I just thought it might be useful or interesting for you to see what proofs look like when they come from the printer. This is part of the book writing process, well, the book production process, that you need to check the colour, you need to check that everything's in the, on the right pages, in the right place and all that sort of thing. And at this stage, this is pretty much the last chance I have to make any changes. After this, it goes to press and then it comes back to me as an advanced copy in a little while's time. And I get one last say of approval or refusal at that point. And there'd have to be something terribly wrong with it for me to refuse it at that stage, like something defamatory or some reason why the whole book would have to be pulped. Because at that stage, they've printed the whole print run. And so it's a big expense to say, oh no, there's something wrong, I think I'd like to change this. You wouldn't do it at that stage. You'd wait to the next print run. So back to this. This is the Frisian Whitework runner. I'll try and get it so you can see the whole of the border that goes across the end. So it has a hem-stitched edge around the edge, and on either side of the Frisian whitework border, it's got a Frisian p-hole hem-stitch. So it's like a regular p-hole hem-stitch, but it's a simplified version, and this is the version that they did generally. So this style of border is the sort of thing that you would get down the middle of a sheet to join the two sides of the sheet together. So the width that they wove in wasn't large enough to go across a whole bed, so they joined two narrow widths together with something like this, and often much more elaborate even, down the center. So within this section here, there was probably some sort of very insignificant join. They did it quite expertly so you couldn't tell. And then on either side of that, they would have the two panels of linen, which made up the sheet, and they'd probably have a large alphabet letter on one side and the other large alphabet letter on the other side, or they might have them both on one side. So it would be the alphabet letters would be the way to, they were the marking, the laundry marking, so that when it went off to be laundered, it came back to the right person. But they obviously became quite elaborate and much more than just a utilitarian thing. So the design that I have put here, I'm just trying to check that I've got the right way for you. Yes, the design that I put here has the diagonal satin stitch stars. There are eyelets. There are also buttonhole eyelets. I think this is channel stitch, more satin stitch. And then we've got some cut work, and this is a buttonhole arc. And so it just repeats across the whole of the width, or most of the width. It doesn't go right to the edge. And you can see how you could actually choose any band and put it on the end like that to make a very pretty end to your runner. So this is a table runner. I would put it in the center of the table, maybe with a bowl or a vase of flowers or something like that on top of it. But you could also make it a little bit smaller, and it could be a placemat if you wanted to, or you could just make it smaller generally and have a smaller runner. So there's lots of things that you can do with this sort of design, where at each end there's a repeat of the same runner. And the thing is also, you could put more across here, or you could turn the corner and go across the side as well. So there's lots of ways that you could adapt that. So I also wanted to go back to talking about the Dutch heritage fabrics that I've used in a few of the projects. I wanted to show you how gorgeous they are. So this is one of the ones that I've used. This is the one that's used on the back of the Biscornu. Sorry, it takes a while for my brain to work. It's early in the morning. And you can see the beautiful floral designs on it. This comes in a number of colorways. This is the one that I've chosen to use because I'm a bit of a sucker for red. And it's just gorgeous. I love the look of that fabric. Then the other one that I have used is this one here, which has got similar sorts of tones, but much more blue and with some yellow as well. And it also comes in a range of colorways. This is the one I've used. And you can see the gorgeous floral designs. So the style that is chintz. That's known as chintz generally. And I wanted to alert you to two exhibitions that are coming up. And I'm going to read this so that I don't get it wrong. The Fashion and Textile Museum in London has a forthcoming exhibition called Chintz Cotton in Bloom. And it runs from lockdown pending. So let's assume that you'll be all out of lockdown by then and you'll be able to mix freely in society. So from the 18th of May to the 15th of August. If you're interested in this exhibition, just keep an eye on their website. And if they have to update the dates, I'm sure they will update it on their website. So it has all of these sorts of beautiful fabrics in it. And interestingly, the exhibition was first mounted by the Fries Museum in Leeuwarden in the Netherlands, which is the museum that I went to do the research for my book on Frisian whitework. And so you can see that chintz and these sorts of beautiful fabrics are integral to their textiles culture there, or have been in the past. Hopefully they still are. And so they put together this beautiful exhibition of beautiful pieces of clothing with chintz fabric and other things with chintz fabric. And it's now going to London. And so if you're going to be in London, then look out for it, because if I was there, I would go, definitely. And then the other exhibition that I wanted to tell you about is called Haute Boudure, and it is also being mounted by the Fries Museum in Leeuwarden in the Netherlands, and it's going to be four centuries of handmade embroidery in Dutch fashion. Wow, I would love to see it. So it's running and also lockdown pending. So just check their website for the dates if you're making any plans, from the 16th of March to the 18th of July. I actually have a feeling that it was supposed to have opened already, but they put the dates back because they're not able to open the museum yet. So both of those will be fabulous, beautiful gorgeous exhibitions that I would dearly love to see and am not able to because I'm stuck in Australia and the exhibitions aren't open yet anyway. So, something to look forward to for those of you who are in lockdown in those areas. Things that are coming. So I'm going to put the links to the websites for the exhibitions there down below so that you can check out those websites and see what's coming and have a look and a little drool. And if you're like me and can't actually get there, that's probably all you'll get to see of it. And so enjoy what you can. So thank you so much for joining me again today, and I will see you next time. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. Thanks. Bye.